Welcome to the Crypto Sphere. This is Cryptogenic coming at you. Today is Monday, December 20th at 9:55 a.m. here in sunny, drizzly, somewhat cold California. It's not cold compared to other places in the world, but it's cold for California. It's cold for the Bay Area, at least. We're going to take a look at this crypto market today, and we're going to see where we are in terms of the bearish scenario, in terms of the bullish scenario. How much longer we're going to consolidate before we see a dramatic breakout in the market. But before we turn to these charts, I'm developing what I call a philosophy of cryptocurrency. Now, a philosophy of anything, the word philosophy is comprised, it's a contraction of two Greek terms, phileo, which means love, and sophia, which means wisdom. So a philosophy of anything is an attempt to approach it from the perspective of a love for wisdom. In other words, how do I love wisdom? How do I demonstrate a love for wisdom in my engagement in this sphere? Now, I am convinced that wisdom demands that I invest in cryptocurrency. In other words, I believe that investing in cryptocurrency is a wise thing to do, and the question is why? And the answer to that question is simple. The promise of cryptocurrency is that it makes wealth accumulation universally accessible. I'm going to say that again. The promise of cryptocurrency is the universal accessibility of wealth accumulation. Prior to the advent of the crypto revolution, the vehicles of wealth accumulation were largely inaccessible to the majority of the population of the world. I mean, think about it. You had gold and silver, precious metals. You have large swaths of the world's population that have no access to gold, silver, or precious metals. You had stocks and ETFs, hedge funds, mutual funds, which were largely inaccessible to large swaths of the world's population. Oil. How about real estate, which continues to be largely inaccessible to large swaths of the world's population. But then you have cryptocurrency, where you can buy $10 of it. You can buy $5 of it. There's no minimum buy-in. And suddenly you have a vehicle of wealth accumulation that is accessible to most of the world's population, still not accessible to all of the world's population. And in actuality, the great challenge that we're facing is mass adoption. It has to become more accessible. That is, it's accessible, but it's inaccessible. And, you know, most of us, you know, us crypto purists, we hate things like Robinhood simply because, you know, you don't actually own the currencies that you buy on Robinhood. But the value of Robinhood is that it took things that were largely inaccessible and made them widely accessible to large swaths of the world's population. And so suddenly the average person could open a Robinhood account and invest in the stock market. And then they added crypto, and large portions of the world population could invest in cryptocurrency. And so the point that I'm making is that accessibility is the key to mass adoption, and the vehicles of accessibility, the vehicles that make the crypto market more and more accessible to the masses, are going to facilitate mass adoption. Those are also going to be the most profitable platforms, the most profitable vehicles to invest in the future. Now, why am I talking about this today? I'm talking about this today because if we see the promise of crypto as making wealth accumulation accessible to the masses, then we begin to rejoice in pullbacks and consolidation. Let me tell you where I'm coming from. I hate poverty. I think poverty is demonic. Poverty, in my opinion, devalues, diminishes the value of the human person. It robs the human person of the dignity the common dignities that every human person deserves by virtue of being a human person. Maslow talks about those basic needs that we would call basic values as being a hierarchy that starts on the very bottom with food and shelter, and then next is safety and security, and then love and acceptance, and then self-confidence, and then finally at the top of that was what he would call self-actualization. What poverty does is it robs us of the bottom two and the top two. Extreme poverty means you've got no food and shelter, you got no safety and security. You can still have some love and acceptance, but you're not going to have very much self-confidence and no access to self-actualization. And so what crypto does, in my opinion, is it becomes a vehicle of restoring the dignity of the human person. Everyone has access to it. And that's why I love talking to people about cryptocurrency. You know, I talk to people who are in all lines of work, people who are not people of means, who don't have huge bank accounts or huge money bags laying around. But they get excited when they realize that they can invest $15 a week in the crypto market, or $15 a month in the crypto market, and that $15 could be worth $150 in a year. And if you do that month upon month upon month, you could actually accelerate your retirement. You could actually pull yourself out of a situation of poverty, rat race, struggle. I see it as a potential. I just believe every human person should have the opportunity to accumulate wealth. And the prevailing system, the prevailing economic system, does not provide that. The prevailing economic system is designed to further enrich the rich and further impoverish the poor. It's designed to do that, and it's designed by the rich to do that. So when I see these pullbacks, and when I see these red candles, and you know, when I see the possibility of extended consolidation, when I think of the concept of an extended market cycle that extends all the way till August of next year, a slow grind instead of quick blow-off tops that happen in 3 weeks, that excites me. And the reason it excites me is that if there's going to be a slow grind between now and August, that means more people will have the opportunity to get in. It's going to change a lot more lives. And for those of us who are, you know, impatient and hasty because we've already, you know, got a substantial amount invested in the market, it gives us the opportunity to become less selfish and say, you know what? At the end of the day, if more people have an extended opportunity to get in on this, not only will more people experience the benefits of the bull run, but I'll actually be wealthier at the end of the day as well, because I'll have a more extended opportunity to accumulate. So that's where patience comes from for me. That's where the patience comes from, is that there's a benevolence to consolidation. We got to see it that way, that there is a benevolence to consolidation events that provide an extended opportunity for more people to get into the market. And so with that being said, let's turn to these charts and let's see what the charts tell us about where we are and where we're going. All right, so really not much has changed. Looking at this BTC chart, this was the bearish scenario that I charted, and I charted it before it broke down, said we needed to be aware of it, and sure enough, it began to play out. Thankfully, it has not as of yet played out to this degree, and honestly, I don't expect it to, and here is why. Number one, we've got this uptrend in the price, and we've got a downtrend in the RSI, which is hidden bullish divergence. Hidden bullish divergence on the weekly chart precipitates a continuing bullish move. Now, looking at the broader macro pattern, we're making higher highs in the price, and here we're making higher highs in the RSI, which means, yes, we topped out here, we had a downtrend, but now there is a new trend in terms of highs in the RSI, and we are making higher highs. And so if this trend continues, we're going to come back up and touch the top of this again, and we might come back up and touch it again. And if this pattern continues to August, as I expect, we could make two more trips to the top. You know, we could do something like, you know, come up to the top, come down even to the bottom, and come up to the top again. Sorry, my drawing is terrible. Before this market tops out. Now, is that going to happen? I don't know, but we're going to have to wait and see. But if that is the case, I expect a bullish break above this trend here. And I expect, and I expect Bitcoin to continue its epic rise. I'm convinced that the Bitcoin bull run is not over. And, you know, of course, there's a lot of people in the market that don't believe in me, or that don't agree with me, not that don't believe in me, that don't agree with me. And that's fine, but we shall see. But looking at this total crypto market cap, once again, hidden bullish divergence, it's very clear. It's an uptrend in the lows of the price, a downtrend in the lows of the RSI. That's hidden bullish divergence. Looking at the altcoin market, hidden bullish divergence, and it's becoming more pronounced. Uptrend, downtrend, okay? That's hidden bullish divergence. Now, going over here to this Bitcoin chart, if we just zoom out and look at it from a macro perspective, all we need to do is just pull this line down a little bit, redraw the trend. The trend is still bullish because we're still making higher lows in the price. See that? Forget that. Just understand that this low is higher than this low, and this low is higher than this low. We're still making higher lows in the price and higher lows in the RSI. The RSI is coming right down to support at the bottom of that trend. We could even draw that trend like this and say we've got quite a ways to come down, but this line here needs to hold in the RSI, and for all intents and purposes, it's holding fine. We still have every opportunity to come back and revisit the top of this line between now and August before we actually top out. And if Bitcoin comes back up and visits the top of this line, remember, every time we visit the top of the line, it's still about 6 more weeks before the price actually tops out. So if we're looking at an extended cycle, which I believe we are, we're right on schedule. Everything's fine. It's just taking some time. Now, looking at Ethereum, Ethereum is bullish against BTC. Ethereum looks like it's going to very easily and strongly outperform BTC by up to 400%. We can draw another trend line here. And, you know, that amount reduces the percentage by which it outperforms BTC. Reduces. Let's see, it comes in at about 185%, but even still, for all intents and purposes, I think it's clear that if this chart is correct, Ethereum is going to outperform BTC in the next market. And so, as I've been saying, all we need to do is look for assets that are going to outperform Ethereum. Looking at the USD chart, Ethereum once again is showing hidden bullish divergence. It's flat, slightly bearish in the RSI, but it's bullish in the price. Higher lows, lower lows, flatter, lower lows. That is hidden bullish divergence. So that means that the run for Ethereum is not over yet. XRP is bullish. Look at this. It's hidden bullish divergence. It's very clear hidden bullish divergence. We're making higher lows in the, actually, higher lows in the RSI. No. Lower lows in the price. This is bullish divergence, regular bullish divergence. This is not hidden bullish divergence. Regular, it's higher lows in the RSI, lower lows in the price, that's bullish divergence. And so, and secondly, this is a descending, narrowing wedge, which is bullish. And so I'm expecting a bullish break from this range in the RSI and a bullish break here in the price. XRP is going to outperform Ethereum. And if we can kind of get a feel for this, for by what percentage XRP will outperform Ethereum. Let's say we break out here. So basically by about 400%. I could see really the revisiting of the top of this line, at least for XRP. Same thing with LINK. It's a descending narrowing wedge. It's going to break out bullish. I'm expecting that for LINK. I really want to revisit LINK because I think I haven't given LINK enough credit. I think once, you know, we got hidden bullish divergence here in the RSI, just like everything else. But I think LINK can hit some of these higher levels between now and August. And yeah, I think LINK is going to be strong. But look at BCH. This is clear bullish divergence in the RSI. It's not hidden bullish. It's just regular bullish divergence. The RSI started telegraphing all the way back in 2020, in August of 2020, that actually, if we move it up here, yeah, December 2020, the RSI started telegraphing that BCH is going to outperform Ethereum by a large margin. Look at this. We're coming to the end of this triangle here. Once we get a break above this line in the RSI, I mean, look how undersold it was, or oversold it was. Way oversold. Okay? Underbought. Once we get a break here, we should see a breakout for BCH, and we need a breakout for BCH. Rune. Thor chain. Looks like it's going to need some more time to consolidate. It's breaking down here. It's breaking down in the price and breaking down in the RSI. There's no hidden bullish divergence on this chart. It's just bearish. So that simply means for me that Rune is entering back into an accumulation phase. And it would be good to continue for me. It would be good to continue to accumulate it, which is pretty sad because it was breaking out so strong here. Now it's breaking down. But that's okay. It just means that we're back in an accumulation phase for Rune, and we'll probably be in that accumulation phase for a while, it looks like, until we can see a recovery here in the RSI and the price. But that doesn't look like it's going to happen soon. So what happens for me is when I expect bullishness, but I get bearishness, I just hold and accumulate more. I looked at Chili's against ETH. We got a huge bull pennant. Okay, so, yeah, once we get a bullish break, this stuff should outperform ETH by large margins. But, I mean, it's flat in the price. It's flattening in the RSI, but this is a big bull pennant. And should we break bullish above this, we should outperform Ethereum, depending on where we break bullish above it, by like 584%. So anyway, this is what I'm seeing, folks. So basically revisiting the top of this, even a little bit above the top of this pattern against Ethereum. All right, folks, that's all I got for you today. All is well. Do me a favor and smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, smash that bell so that you get notified every time I put out a new video. And above all, make it your aim to sleep in peace every night, wake in joy every morning, and walk in love every day. And remember, this is not financial advice. I'm not a financial advisor. Simply telling you what I see in these charts, and that's it. Not telling you to buy, not telling you to not buy. And with that being said, this is Cryptogenic signing out.